So it's generally believed that eating protein stimulates muscle protein synthesis up to a point after which those amino acids are broken down and no further protein synthesis occurs. This is why you've probably heard about people talking about you should only eat between 25 and 30 grams of protein a meal because anything beyond that is a waste of time. But is this really true? A new study just came out may change your thoughts on this. So here's the paper I'm talking about: the anabolic response to protein ingestion during recovery from exercise has no upper limit on the magnitude and duration in humans. So basically, the title of this study tells us everything we need to know, but let's take a closer look at what happened. So we have 36 healthy young guys. They're given a single bout of a total body strength training program. And as you can see, as I'm showing you here, it's essentially a big muscle group, compound group exercise program targeting the largest muscles of the body, the legs, the chest, and the back. Afterwards, they're given a drink that contains either zero protein, 25 grams of protein, or a whopping 100 grams of protein dissolved in water. After which, there's blood tests and muscle biopsies that are performed on these guys to get a better idea of what's happening in terms of muscle protein synthesis. So what did they actually find? So one outcome which should come as no surprise to anybody, and that is that consuming 25 grams of protein resulted in greater muscle protein synthesis than guys who only exercised and did not get protein after exercise. That makes total sense. However, consuming 100 grams of protein resulted in a greater rise in plasma amino acids, and this elevation in amino acid stayed higher for the 12 hours after they continued to do measurements. And it gets better still. Consuming 100 grams of protein resulted in between 14 and 20% greater muscle protein synthesis compared to just eating 25 grams. And this protein synthesis continued for up to 12 hours. Additionally, those guys who got the 100 grams of protein also saw about a 40% improvement in myofibril protein synthesis compared to those who only got 25 grams. Now, I thought this was important because the myofibrils are essentially tiny muscle fibers that make up your muscle fibers, and it's within the myofibrils that you find the contractile filaments like actin and myosin. In other words, improvements in myofibril protein synthesis means greater overall muscle protein synthesis, which in turn might lead to muscles getting bigger and stronger over time. Equally interesting in this paper is that it's also reported that 100 grams of protein also significantly increased connective tissue protein synthesis as well. Now, in theory, this means that improvements in connective tissue protein synthesis might actually benefit people who have ligament and tendon injuries. Something else that was reported in this paper was that eating either 25 grams or 100 grams of protein did increase the breakdown or oxidation of amino acids. However, the breakdown of those amino acids in both groups was deemed to be negligible. In other words, the degree of protein synthesis outweighed any breakdown of amino acids that were observed in this study. Now, let's keep in mind, in this study, the researchers were using milk protein, which is a combination of fast-digesting proteins like whey protein and slower-digesting proteins like casein. So I bring this up because you may be wondering, what does this mean for those of you who may be taking whey protein supplements? So I looked into this and found this interesting paper where young men were given 45 grams of either whey protein concentrate or casein isolate after an evening bout of exercise before going to bed. Here it was reported that the degree of muscle protein synthesis did not differ between either whey or casein ingestion. In other words, don't overthink this and pick the protein supplement you like because they all appear to have the same effect on muscle protein synthesis. What do you think of all this? Leave a comment below and also let me know how much protein you're using.